Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 97th Spring Convocation. The ceremony will begin shortly. At this time, I ask you to please stand for the procession of the graduands.
Hey, I'll wait.
would ask that you direct your attention to the screens on either side of the stage. We will now be showing our This Is The Moment video, which provides a snapshot of your Brock experience. You are now moving to a new chapter as part of our alumni community.
This is the moment that defines what happens next. This is the moment you knew what you wanted. And this is the moment you got it. This is the moment you said goodbye. And this is the moment you missed. This is the moment the distance was surprisingly short. And this is the moment the distance was painfully long. This is the moment you opened the door to a new house. And this is the moment it became a home. This is the moment you took some notes. This is the moment you took it all in. This is the moment you fell in love. And this is the moment you fell asleep. This is the moment she told you to take a hike. And this is the moment you did. This is the moment you reached for new heights. And this is the moment you reached new land. This is the moment you learned something new. And this is the moment you had to remember it. This is the moment you were overwhelmed. This is the moment you overachieved. This is the moment you stopped. This is the moment you caught your breath. And this is the moment it was taken away. This is the moment you took the night. And this is the moment you took the stage. This is the moment you say you'll never forget. This is the moment they won't let you. This is the moment you wondered how you would do it. This is the moment you realized why you are here. This is your proudest moment. This is their proudest moment. This is the moment you realize the importance of this moment. And this is the moment that defines what happens next.
Please remain seated. The faculty procession will begin shortly. Session is about to begin. Please rise at the sounding of the fanfare. Thank you. Please be seated. I declare the 97th convocation for the conferring of degrees and certificates in session. Acting Chancellor and President Dr. Lightstone, Acting Vice Chancellor and Provost Dr. McCartney, Trustee D. Pietro, Senate Vice Chair Henderson, platform guests, graduating students, parents, and friends. Welcome to Brock University's Spring Convocation, a time of celebration for our students, families, and friends. It is my pleasure this morning to introduce from the Chancellor's procession, Dr. Jack Lightstone, Acting Chancellor and President of Brock University, Dr. Neil McCartney, Acting Vice Chancellor, Provost, and Vice President Academic of Brock University, Mr. Nick DiPietro, Brock University Board of Trustees, Mr. Brian Hutchings, Vice President, Finance and Administration, Dr. Scott Henderson, Mace Bearer and Vice Chair, Brock University Senate, Mr. Mark Arthur, President of Industrial Alliance Private Wealth Management, and our guest this morning to deliver the convocation address, Dr. Michael Pliley, Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies, Dr. Gary Libben, Vice President, Research, Dr. Don Sear, Dean, Goodman School of Business, Ms. Kim Mead, Vice Provost and Associate Vice President, Student Services, Dr. Greg Finn, Vice Provost and Associate Vice President, Academic. And joining them on stage are university senators, faculty, staff, and student representatives from across the university. I would ask them to also please stand together and be recognized with their colleagues. Please be seated. I now invite President Lightstone to deliver words of welcome.
Provost McCartney, Trustee DiPietro, Senate Chair Henderson, our special convocation speaker, Mr. Arthur, members of the administration, faculty, and staff of Brock University, family and friends of the graduates, welcome and good morning. And to you, graduates of the Goodman School of Business of Brock University, a very special welcome indeed. On behalf of the Brock community, I would like to begin by acknowledging and honoring the ancestors of those on whose traditional lands we gather today. Brock University is located along what today is known as the Bruce Trail, on the traditional shared territory of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and the Attawandaron. And today we acknowledge the First Nation, Métis and Inuit peoples and all Indigenous peoples who have joined us for this convocation. Now, graduates, you look very subdued. Are you happy to be graduating? Family and friends of the graduates, are you happy that they're graduating today? So, graduates, I imagine that you're relieved to be here today, but they are much more relieved than you are. But, of course, what you hear in their voices and cheers is how proud they are of you. And you, of course, have every right to be proud of yourselves. And you should also know that those of us who work at the university, represented by those on the platform party, are also proud of you, because in a real sense, today represents not only the culmination of your work, but it also represents the culmination of our work as well, in a very concrete terms. And therefore, we share in the joy that you feel, and obviously your family and friends feel, and we share in the pride that they have for you as well. Now, graduation, as you can see, is a very formalized event. After all, first the graduates parade in to 18th century music, and then the members of the platform party parade in to late 18th century music, I might add. And we're all here dressed in the height of fashion, you graduates and those of us on the platform, the height of fashion for the 16th century. But despite the ritual and the formalities, I want everyone here to know that today is above all a day of celebration. And therefore, I want all of you to know that when your friend or your loved one crosses the stage to receive his or her diploma, I want everyone to know that it's okay to scream and hoot and holler and whistle and stamp your feet and yell as loud as you want to in order to celebrate this momentous event. And to get everyone in the right mood, we will have a practice run on the count of three. One, two, three. Enjoy convocation.
It is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Nick DiPietro, member of the Board of Trustees, who will present the Spirit of Brock Medal. Mr. DiPietro has served on the Board of Trustees since 2010 and is currently the chair of the Board's Financial Planning, Investment, and Human Resources Committee. He brings a wealth of business and volunteer experience to the university. He is an accomplished and proven entrepreneur and business executive. He presided over the establishment of Patheon Incorporated as a global leader in pharmaceutical development manufacturing services, and is now president and CEO of Natacor Incorporated, a venture capital and management services company which he founded. He is a graduate of McMaster University, where he received an honors Bachelor of Science in biochemistry and an MBA. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Nick DiPietro.
Dr. Lightstone, honored guests, faculty, staff, and graduates. The Board of Trustees recognizes the commitment, dedication, and sacrifice that it takes to become a graduate of Brock University. We take great pride in your achievements and share with you and your family in the celebration of your success. As part of the celebration, the Board of Trustees created a unique award in order to pay tribute to the outstanding achievements and contributions of graduating students. During the spring convocation, the Board of Trustees' Spirit of Brock Medal will be awarded to an undergraduate and graduate student who best exemplifies the spirit of Sir Isaac Brock. Students who demonstrate any one or more of the qualities of leadership, courage, innovation, inspiration, and community involvement have been recommended to receive the award by the respective faculty dean. Today, I have the honor to present the Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal to Goodman School of Business graduate student Andrew Ware. Andrew, please come forward. I've asked Andrew to sit here for a moment while I tell you a few special things about him. Andrew Ware is graduating from the Goodman MBA program with a specialization in accounting. After almost 9 years in the workforce with a wife, two children, and a mortgage, Andrew made the and a lovely daughter. This is Aurora, everyone. Anyway, Andrew made the bold, the courageous decision to go back to school to further advance his career. He has successfully completed the program with a high academic average while actively being involved in school activities and volunteering his time to the community. While pursuing his degree, Andrew was a student ambassador for the Certified Management Accountants of Ontario, competition coordinator for the Graduate Business Council, and a participant in the Brock Student Leader Summit and MBA Games. Andrew's community involvement includes being a member of the Junior Chamber of Commerce at the local, regional, and national levels, where he notably won the award for being the most outstanding local president in Canada, and helping families in need through Habitat for Humanity in Niagara. Among other recognition awards he has received, Andrew was named one of the 40 under 40 in business in Niagara by the Business Link newspaper, and received the Volunteer Recognition Award from the City of St. Catharines. His referees described him as being a strong and dynamic leader, professional and compassionate, dedicated and caring. He described himself as the shy guy, but now regularly speaks publicly in a leadership program as a leadership program trainer. Andrew now works in Niagara at a job he was offered after successfully completing a co-op work term with that same company. Again, please join me in congratulating Andrew Ware. And Aurora.
Future Goodman student. I now take pleasure in inviting Mr. Mark Arthur to deliver the convocation address to you graduates of the Goodman School of Business.
First, let me congratulate the class of 2015. You have worked hard. Be proud of what you have achieved. Your parents, families, and your friends are proud of you. The provost has allocated me 7 minutes in today's program, a true test of my communication skills, or a comment on the growing technology-induced attention deficit tendencies of our society. Let me present 6 thoughts for you as you move forward in your lives. First, the world awaits you. The opportunities in front of each of you are endless. They are limited only by your ability to see what they are. Be prepared as you move through your career to be constantly asking yourself, what am I doing to make the world a better place? When I was your age, I had no idea of the many twists and turns that my career would take. After getting my undergraduate degree from Brock, I took a job described as first-level management with Bell Canada. There were not a lot of choices at the time. The school was rather new. It sounded good. It turned out I was sent to Owen Sound as a foreman of a crew sticking up telephone poles. I quickly decided I was not going to do that for the rest of my life. But it was a start, and we all have to start somewhere. After my MBA, I started at a privately held, hugely entrepreneurial, and aggressive investment banking firm, which was bought 9 years later by the largest bank in Canada. And after a combined 22 years, I left and became an entrepreneur, co-founding a small financial services conglomerate to be bought 10 years later by the fourth largest insurance company in Canada, where I am now. I mean, who knew? Do not be afraid to go for the entrepreneurial route. Be prepared to take risks, embrace failure, and learn from it. It is hard work, but hugely satisfying and particularly liberating to be your own boss. Embody the university spirit in a willingness to be bold and strike out in new directions. Whatever you do, seize the opportunity. My second point has to do with differentiating yourself. I could quote endless statistics about the intensity of competition among countries, within industries, between companies, or the number of students in North America or globally graduating with business degrees. Now that you are entering the real world on a full-time basis, how are you going to differentiate yourself? I went and did an MBA after Brock and a CFA. They are not the only ways. Take on the tough assignments, take the offshore posting, work more effectively, excel at teamwork, be well-read, become a specialist. There are lots of ways to add value and to differentiate yourself from the pack. Although you have just graduated, this is only the first step. You need to continually learn and reinvent yourself in order to have a long and successful career. My third thought has to do with managing people. If you want to be successful, whether it is running your own company or within a larger company, you will have to become quite skilled at managing people. Before I was 30, I was put in charge of a $1 billion private client asset management company. The youngest portfolio manager had 20 years on me. It was definitely sink or swim. In my view, success requires that one must be able to paint a vision of the future or a brightness of the future. What does success look like? How are we going to get there? What do we need to do, etc.? And you must do this on a regular basis. Furthermore, management requires a frequent and high level of people interaction, which leads me to my fourth point, communication skills. Despite the massive technology changes in the field of communications, I am surprised at how often I run across people in business who cannot express their ideas, either verbally, in a memo, in a PowerPoint, or whatever method they choose, in a successful manner. Let me put on my cranky boss hat. The boss is busy, wants to know the issue, why is it important, what the impact will be, what two options are you putting forward, and what is your recommendation? If the boss wants more, they will ask. Time spent honing your communication skills is well spent. My fifth comment has to do with decision making. You must master the art of making decisions. Yes, it is an art, not a science. You will be forced to learn to make decisions with imperfect information. At the speed of today's business, no one has the luxury of waiting for that extra elusive piece of information that will give you the confidence that your decision is perfect. There are two keys to decision making. The first is to make a decision. How many times have businesses been paralyzed by teams or bosses that struggle to make decisions? The second key is to be prepared to accept that a decent percentage of your decisions are going to be wrong. But as soon as you have the additional information, to know that the decision you made is wrong, admit it and quickly move to make a new decision. Nothing will kill your career or a company faster than the inability to make a decision or a prolonged defense of a bad decision. My sixth point has to do with work-life balance. You may achieve success by working 16 hours a day, and I have certainly done that. For 5 years in my life, I was the chief spokesman for the RBC's Global Mutual Fund family. During the RSP season, I spent every single lunch hour and every single evening in a different city, one at lunch, one in the evening, giving a speech. You do that for 8 weeks in a row, so that's sort of 40 nights, work nights in a row. You know, they give you those plastic cards to get into an elevator and get to your room. I would get to the stage where I could get into the elevator and not know what button to push. And if I was lucky to remember what button to push, which way to turn when I got off the elevator. It's not a great way to live. A career should be fun. There is no dress rehearsal. Life is short. If you're not having fun, then pack up and move on. True happiness requires a balance between work and life, which includes your friends, your family, and ultimately your children, your outside interests. I cannot stress enough how important that is. I somehow doubt when you are sitting in that rocking chair at the age of 90, that you will be saying, I should have worked harder. So let me leave you with these six thoughts. Seize the opportunity, be prepared to differentiate yourselves, be able to paint a vision of the future, communicate, make decisions, and watch the work-life balance. Again, let me congratulate the class of 2015. We eagerly await your contributions to our society. Thank you.
Wise words indeed. Will the candidates for the various degrees please rise? With the degrees about to be conferred upon you, there comes a certain expectation that you will continue sincerely in the pursuit of learning and truth, and that as far as in you lies, you will promote the interests and welfare of your university. Do you acknowledge this expectation? Mr. Chancellor, as the candidates have acknowledged the responsibilities that accompany their degrees and as they have successfully completed the courses of study prescribed by Senate, I would ask that you admit them to their several degrees and certificates.
It is my pleasure to admit you all. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Master of Business Administration.
Sahil Anand, Venugopal Balakrishna. Yatish Bangalore Ningashetty, Tashvin Yamin Bashar, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. Lydia Belosova, Claire Elizabeth Cameron. Roberto Carmona Meredith, Akanksha Chaturvedi. Chun Chen, Li Rong Chen. Mongju Cheng, Si Cheng. Si Chao Ju, Gavin Cook. Tan Cui, Yin Qing Dong. Jayan Dorisami, Tan Du, Zanaldik Jenna Dustinova, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award, Chung Hao Fan. Yan Qin Fang, Rushane Fernandez. Xiang Gao, Anisha Gopi. Kyle Grundy, Jia Yi Gu. Gu Chao Zhong Guo. Jin Guo Xu Qian Guo. Xiao Ying Han Yang Han. Wei He, Yan He. Yu Long He, Jordan Heeslip. Alan Ho, Sherry Ho. Xin Zhou Hu, Pei Yan Huang. Xu Rong Huang, Tyler Huizinga, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. James Jessup. Jian Xuan Jiang. Yu Jiang Yashintin. Krishna Kumar Joshi, Alexander Karyev. Tyler Robert Raymond Kasubek, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. Amanda Ellen Keyes. Khalid Khan, De Chun Kong. Anna Levashova, Tian Chao Li. Jing Fei Li, Meng. Jia Li.
Thank you.
Si Zhi Li, Yin Xiao Li. Zuo Xin Li, Cheng Liu. Fang Zhou Liu, Tong Liu. De Jia Lu, Min Luo. Xin Yu Liu, Sarisha Rani Mirakula. Brett Mitchell, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. Elizabeth Morgan. Bradley Richard Newdorf. Zachary Nichols, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. Tian Yu Pang. Hao Peng. Konstantin Podivilko. Samuel Prentice. Qi Tu Wei Tuan. Arsalan Saleem, Mohammed Shahzad. Matthew Smith, Miranda Smoore. Victor Stranges, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award, Shi Han Sun. Sukant Thandra, Xia Tian. Yao Rong Tian, Ji. Tong. Christopher Ryan Treshak, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award. Chijit Verma. Wang, Ming Zi Wang. Wang, Si Yan Wang, Tian Pei Wang, Xiao Lei Wang, Xiao Xu Wang, Xin Wang. Wang, Yu Chen Wang, Yu Ting Wang, Yu Ting Wang. Andrew Ware, recipient of the Goodman School of Business Graduate Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal. Jiao Wu. Liu Wu. Xiao Dan Wu. Yin Tian Wu, Yi Ran Xia. Han Yu Xiao, Tian Wen Xiao. Jin Xie, Hang Xu. Jin Xu, Fei Ya Yan. Not just yet. Xin Yan, Fan Yang. Xin Yi Yang. Hong Yang Yin. Di Yu Xin Bo Yu. Yu Wei Yuan. Xu Jin Yue. Maria Yurikova, Xiao Yu Dai, Jinghang Zhang, Lu Zhang, Xiao Yi Zhang, Nicholas Zhang, Xuan Zhang, Xu Gong Zhang, Qinan Zhao, Jia Zhong. Ru Yu Zheng. Chuan Zhou. Tongzhou Xiangzhou. Xiangnanzhou Xianzhou. Yangzhou, Yongmingzhou. Si Si Ju, recipient of the Goodman Graduation Award.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Accounting honors.
Mohammed Arslan Abbas, Luisito Anglo. Gunvir Alec. James Baird. Manmeet Banwait with first class standing. Lena Bazin with first class standing. Madison Brianne Beatum. Sharon Buller, Rose Buller, twin sisters.
Twins. Yeah, they're two Bullers.
Kane Big Canoe. Katie Cambone Manel. Jessica Tsu Wing Chan. Richard Chan. Lu Chen. Ji Dun Chen. Zhou Yin Chen. Ling Cheng. Ruo Nan Cheng. Richie T. Ho Cheng with first class standing. Joshua Thomas Chin. Amanda Chistoff. Mark Anthony Chong, Courtney Margaret Clark. Michael Cosentino with first class standing. Xinwen Cui with first class standing. Bo Wan Dong, Blue Braden DeRosier. Manrose Darney, Erica Julianne Kendall Dix. Christopher D'Orazio, Stephen James Enns with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, BIAC, the Goodman School of Business, the Maurice Perkins Award, and the Goodman School of Business Academic Award of Excellence Bachelor of Accounting, and the Award of Excellence for Outstanding Academic Achievement. Nader Fidel with first class standing. Samantha Fielder. Vincent James Filomeni. Andrea Figuera. Brandon Richard Gossenbeek with first class standing. Samantha Andrea Galbraith. Sonali Garg, Leon Gash. Kevin Jennings, Max Gong. Griffin Wesley Grant Gray. Matthew Greer with first class standing. Jason Grunninger, Ti Guo. Danielle Hager with first class standing. Sarah Halim. Angela Havowick, recipient of the Outstanding Contribution to Co-op Award for the Bachelor of Accounting and the Goodman Undergraduate Graduating Scholarship. Matthew Robert Herman, with first class standing. Scott High. Jing Huang, with first class standing. Sarah Islami, Kunal Jagata. Jet Jiang with first class standing, recipient of the Goodman Undergraduate Graduating Scholarship. Ming Ji Jin. Xuan Jin. Joseph Tyre Jongling. Meyer Capitan. S.J. Katyal with first class standing. William James Koopmans. Costa Kreischnick. Jessica Krebs Vandelustrecht, with first class standing, recipient of the Goodman Undergraduate Graduating Scholarship. Krishnan Kuganesan. April Connie Labate. Natalie Leung. Qing Tuan Li. Kevin Liberona. Sarah Lim. Ku Fei Kevin Liu. Liu, Zhen Xu Liu, Anojin Lokanathan, Nethmi Lokuliu. Loculiana. Si Tao Lu. Newton Luo. Shaolei Ma. Michael David McDowell. Patrick Ma with first class standing. Nauman Malik. Stephen Mon, Elfie Deason Mangrobang. Stephen Lewis Manel, Maxim Marchuk. Teresa Aaron Mason with first class standing, Raymond Maxwell. Kelly McGinnis. Si Yu Meng with first class standing. Lauren Morrison with first class standing. Jillian Mary Myers. Aisha Othman with first class standing. Piradipa Parameswaran. Matisha Patel with first class standing. Mukul Patel. Zach Penny.
Yeah, I know.
Mitulin Karen Panijam with first class standing. Song Chow with first class standing. Laura Redmond. Melissa Rennick Purcell. Kimberly Robinson. Bilal Sabzwari. Adam Anthony Saccone with first class standing. Sarbjot Sandhu with first class standing. Simmer Sangha. Emily Gail Shopman. Carolyn Shee. Brady Schultz with first class standing. Gagandeep Singh Sidhu. Pavan Skaria. Brian Andrew Smith with first class standing. Jia Ray Song, Joel Michael Stapley. Amir Mohammed Tanvir, Belal Tariq. Stephen Toma. T. Nok Dang Tran. Ayaz Umarwadia with first class standing. Joshua Jordan Vermette. Yeah. Chunying Wang, Ding Wang, with first class standing. Ling Jing Wang, Billy Wang. Shan Shan Wang, Yi Chun Wang. Ian Wong, Johnny Wassenaar. Caitlin Rose Webb. Matthew Wetlaufer. Brianna Marie Wilson. Jiaqi Wu. Jonathan Wu with first class standing. Si Qiong Xie. Sha Zhou Xu. Cindy Hyunju Yang with first class standing. Yi Ting Yang. Zhong Hi Yu with first class standing. Zhi Qiang Yu. Xi Zhan. Zhi Hong Zhang, Jun Xi Zhao. Yan Jiang Zhu, Tracy Chang. Jin Shun Lin. Hao Wu Pu.
Mr. Chancellor, whereas certain candidates who have successfully completed the course of studies prescribed by Senate are absent from this convocation for just cause, I request that you confer upon them their degrees and certificate in absentia.
I admit them all in absentia.
The Senate of Brock University has recommended the awarding of a Dean's Medal to the graduate in each faculty with the highest standing in a first honors degree. I take pleasure in inviting Stephen James Enns to accept this award.
My name is Diana Tuschinski. I am very pleased. pleased to congratulate all of you who have received your degree this morning, as well as all of the family and friends in the audience who are bursting with pride at your achievements. As a director of the Brock University Alumni Association and an alumna from the BA program in 1982, I welcome all of you as new alumni of Brock and as new members of our Alumni Association. What does it mean to be an alumni? As of today, you join a membership of more than 86,000 other graduates. Alumni who are willing to connect with you, work with you, mentor you, and advocate for you in your personal growth and professional development. The value of your degree is a reflection of the success of all of our alumni in their careers and in their professional lives. 86,000 plus alumni that are making their positive marks on the world have impact, and that impact raises the value of your degree. But the value of your degree is also a reflection of what happens here at Brock long after you're gone. The quality of the programs, the research, the teaching all intertwine to raise the reputation of Brock and therefore your degree. The reputation of the university is an important stake and one that we hope you take seriously. As you start this new chapter in your lives, we see yourselves as ambassadors of university. Share your Brock experience with others and be sure to share your successes with us. Stay connected to Brock and your Alumni Association. You can email us, call us, tweet us, Facebook us, join our LinkedIn group, subscribe to our alumni publications, attend homecoming, reunions, and other alumni activities. Be in touch with us as often and be proud of your university as we are of you. Take what you've learned at Brock, go out into the world, and improve it. Push on and experience your life to the fullest. Sergite.
Well, we've come to the end of convocation. How does it feel to have graduated? And family and friends, how does it feel to have seen them graduate? Well, you are now, as you've just heard, you are now graduates, you are now alumni of Brock University. And I want to inform you, in case you didn't realize this, that this is an organization from which you can never resign. I'm going to mix an investment portfolio metaphor with a biological one. I'd like to say that you graduates and Brock University now have a lifelong symbiotic relationship. And now to switch to the investment portfolio to explain the biological metaphor. In fact, your degree is like a vested stock. It doesn't have a fixed value. It can go up, it can go down. And it goes up or down based on a number of factors. First of all, it goes up or down based on the successes of your university years after you've attained your degree. If we become more successful, the value of your degree goes up. And by the same token, as you are successful in your careers and in life in general, you add value to the value of the degrees that students will receive from Brock years after today. Years after you graduated. So we and you are linked for the rest of your lives, and we cherish you, and we hope that you will cherish us. And as you've heard from the member of the Alumni Association, stay in touch with us. But I'm here to tell you, if you do not stay in touch with us, we will stay in touch with you. I have only to wish all of you all the best and all the success and happiness in all the days and years that follow today's graduation ceremony. So once again, from all of us, congratulations. Afterwards, after this convocation ceremony, everyone is invited for refreshments in a tent outside of this building, outside to my right, to your left. In a moment, we will rise for the singing of O Canada, but I want to just remind you that after the singing of our national anthem, first the platform party and then the graduates will recess in procession from the hall, a bit more of our ritual. And I would ask everyone else, all the family, friends, and guests, to stay seated until that has happened, and then you can all find one another outside this building. So please rise for the singing of O Canada. I declare this convocation dismissed.